Hello students, today we are going to discuss next point, that is trigonometric ratios of some specific angles. Okay, so in 10th standard we have to discuss only about acute angles, so we have to find the values of trigonometric ratios of angles 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree. Okay, so first we have to find values of 0 degree and 90 degree. Okay, so trigonometric ratios of angles 0 degree and 90 degree. Okay, so suppose XAY, this is a acute angle, okay, and this P point, if we take on ray AY and if we draw perpendicular PM on XA, so we will get triangle PMA, okay, which is a right triangle, right angled at M, okay, and we have to consider this angle as a theta. Okay, so angle PMA is equal to 90 degree. Okay, so triangle PMA is right triangle and angle PAM is equal to theta is an acute angle. Okay, now we have to find the values of trigonometric ratios of angles 0 degree and 90 degree. Okay, so now in this triangle, in triangle PMA, what is sine theta? So sine theta is equal to, now we know that sine theta is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse, so PM divided by PA. Okay, then cos theta, that is adjacent side by hypotenuse, so AM divided by PA, and tan theta is equal to opposite side by adjacent side, so PM divided by AM. Okay, now see here, if you have to find value of this angle, means trigonometric ratios of angle 0 degree, okay, so 0 degree means if we reduce this angle theta, okay, up till 0 degree, so what happen, this PM becomes 0, okay, and this AP coincide with AM, okay, means this P point coincide with M. Okay, so if we reduce this angle theta up till angle 0, so PM is equal to 0 and this AP is equal to AM. Okay, it is like this way. Okay, this is angle theta. Okay, if suppose this is PMA. Okay, so if we reduce this, then it is like this way. Okay, if we reduce up till angle 0, so this AP is coincide with AM and this PM becomes 0. Okay, so if we decrease angle theta up till 0 degree, then PM is equal to 0, okay, this PM becomes 0 and this AP is equal to AM, and AP is equal to AM. So if PM is 0 and AP is equal to AM, what happen about sine theta or sine 0 degree? So sine 0 degree, that is equal to, now PM is 0, so 0 divided by PA, so it is equal to 0. What is about cos 0 degree? that is AM and PA. So AM and PA or AP are equal. So this is AP by AP is equal to 1. So sine 0 is 0, cos 0 is 1. And what is about tan 0? So tan 0, that is PM is 0. So 0 divided by AM. So that is a 0. Okay. So first angle is 0 degree. Sine 0 is 0. Cos 0, that is a 1. Tan 0 is 0. Okay. Similarly for 90 degree. Okay. Now I am rubbing this one. Okay, now for 90 degree, if we increase this angle theta up to 90 degree, then what happen? This M point coincide with A, that is AM is 0, okay, and PM and AP is coincide, okay. It is like this way, okay. Suppose this is M point, this is A, this is P, okay. So if we increase this, first it is here like this way, okay. So M point is here, then here, then here, okay. So what happened here, this AM distance is decreased, okay, and at right angle this AM distance is 0, okay, and this PM is coincide with AP, okay. So if we increase theta till 90 degree, then what happen? Then this AM is equal to 0, okay, AM is equal to 0 and PM is coincide with AP. So PM is equal to AP. So if PM is equal to AP, what is about sine 90 degree? So sine theta, or first we have to write sine theta. Sine theta, that is a PM by AP. Cos theta AM by AP, adjacent side by hypotenuse. And tan theta, that is a PM by AM. Okay, so here sine 90 degree, that is equal to, now here PM and AP equal, so sine 90, that is a 1, because PM upon AP, if we replace by PM, that is a 1. Cos 90 degree, AM is equal to 0, so cos 90 is 0. And tan 90 degree, that is a PM and PM is equal to 0, sorry, tan 90 degree. So if we take here AM is 0, so tan 90 degrees, if we take like this way, PM divided by 0, so it is not defined, okay. So tan 90 degrees not defined, okay. So sine 90 is 1, cos 90 is 0, and tan 90, that is a not defined, okay. Understand this. Now we will take next trigonometric ratio, that is a of 30 degree and 60 degree, okay. Okay, so here one more is done. If now we will write other six trigonometric, means other three trigonometric ratios, values of other three trigonometric ratios for 0 degree and 90 degree. Okay, so here first we know that sine 0 degree is 0. Cos, okay, here I am writing in 0 degree angle. Cos 0 degree, that is a 1, and tan 0 degree, that is a 0, okay. Now for sake, first we have to write cot 0. So cot 0 degree, that is a reciprocal of tan. So tan 0 is 0, so cot 0 is 1 upon tan, that is a 1 upon 0, means not defined. okay. Another one is sec 0 degree. Sec 0 degree, that is a reciprocal of cos 0 degree. So 1 upon 1, so sec 0 degree is 1. And then cosec 0 degree. Cosec 0 degree, that is a reciprocal of sine. So here this is 1 upon 0, cosec 0 degree. So it is a not defined. Okay. Similarly, we have to write for 90 degree. So sine 90 degree, that is a 1. Cos 90 degree, that is 0. Tan 90 degree, that is not defined. Then cot 90 degree. Cot 90 degree, that is a cos 90 divided by sine 90, that is 0 by 1. Okay, cot 90 we can find. Cos, we know that definition of cot theta, that is a cos theta by sin theta. So cos 90 divided by sin 90. So 0 divided by 1, that is a 0. Then sec 90 degree, reciprocal of cos. So here 0 by 1, if we take reciprocal, that is 1 by 0. So it is not defined. Okay. Cosec 90 degree, that is a reciprocal of sin. So here 1 by 1, if we take reciprocal again 1 by 1, so value is 1. So cosec 90 degree is 1. Okay. So this is the value of all trigonometric ratios for angle 0 degree and 90 degree. Okay. Now we will find the values for angles 30 degree and 60 degree. Okay. So this is for 30 degree and 60 degree. Okay. Now for this one, we have to consider equilateral triangle. Okay, suppose this triangle is a ABC, and if we draw perpendicular, suppose this is D. AD is perpendicular on BC, which is angle bisector also, because these two triangles are congruent, so these two angles are equal by CPCT. Okay, so here AD is perpendicular on BC. Okay, so in equilateral triangle all angles are 60 degree. So this angle is 60, this is 60, this is 30 degree, and this is 30 degree. Okay, and we have to consider side of this equilateral triangle is a 2A. Okay, now here if we draw perpendicular AD, then this D is a midpoint of BC, so BD and DC are equal. So this is A and DC also A. Okay, so first we have to write, consider an equilateral triangle ABC of side 2A. Okay, consider an equilateral triangle ABC of side 2A. Okay, now draw perpendicular AD. Draw AD perpendicular on BC. Okay, so here I am not writing this D is midpoint, or these two triangles are congruent triangles. We know that these two triangles are congruent triangles. Okay, so how we show that these two triangles are congruent? Okay, by RHS criteria, because this side is common, this side is equal and right angle. So by RHS criteria, these two triangles congruent. So AD is angle bisector also. So angle BAD and angle CAD, that is 30 degree. Okay, so here triangle, in triangle ABC, AD is perpendicular to BC, therefore D is midpoint of BC. Okay, so if D is midpoint of BC, and right here this also, AD is an angle bisector of angle BAC. Okay, now if we consider any one triangle out of these two triangles, so if I am considering this triangle ADB, so in triangle ADB, angle ADB is equal to 90 degree. Okay, this angle BAD is equal to 30 degree and this is a 60 degree. Okay, now here we have to find values of trigonometric ratios of 30 degree and 60 degree. Okay, so here I am finding values of trigonometric ratios of angles 30 degree. Okay, so first I am writing ratio sine theta is equal to, so suppose here if I am considering angle this A, or here sine of angle BAD, so if we consider this angle BAD, so what is the definition of sine? That is a opposite side divided by hypotenuse. So this is 30 degree, this angle is 30 degree, so opposite side here in front of this BAD angle, opposite side is BD, so BD divided by AB. Okay, similarly cos of angle BAD, that is equal to cos of angle BAD, so that is AD upon AB, because adjacent side of this angle is AD, so AD upon AB. And tan of angle BAD, that is a opposite side upon adjacent side, so opposite side is BD upon adjacent side is AD, so BD divided by AD. Okay, means here sine angle BAD is 30 degree, so sine 30. Now here BD is equal to A, AB is equal to 2A, so A divided by 2A, that is a 1/2, so sine 30 is equal to 1/2. Okay, similarly cos 30 is equal to AD divided by AB. Now we don't have AD, so AD is here, that is a altitude of an equilateral triangle. So we know that formula, that is altitude, how we find, that is root 3/2 into side. Okay, or we can find by using Pythagoras theorem also. If we use Pythagoras theorem in triangle ADB, so we will get length of an altitude. So here you can use either formula or Pythagoras. So here I am using formula root 3/2 into side. So here side is equal to 2a, so if we cut this we will get root 3a, so AD is equal to root 3a, that is a altitude of an equilateral triangle. Okay, now if we put this value here, so root 3a divided by AB is 2a, so this a will get cancelled, cos 30 is equal to root 3/2. Okay, and then tan 30 is equal to BD upon AD, so that is BD is A upon AD is root 3A, so this will get cancelled, that is a 1 upon root 3, so tan 30 value is 1 upon root 3. Okay, now by using this three trigonometric ratios we can write another three trigonometric ratios, that is a cosec 30, it is a reciprocal of sine 30, so sine 30 is 1/2, so cosec 30 is 2, sec 30, this is a reciprocal of cos 30, so cos 30 is root 3/2, sec 30 is 2 upon root 3, and cot 30, that is a reciprocal of tan 30, so tan 30 is 1/√3, cot 30 is root 3/1 or root 3. Okay, now we will write values of trigonometric ratios of angles 60 degree. Okay, so I'm rubbing this one. Okay, now here we have to consider angle which having measure is 60 degree. Now 60 degree is here. Okay, in triangle BAD 60 degrees is this angle, that is a sine of angle ABD, because ABD having measure 60 degree. Now sine of this angle, how we write opposite side of this angle, that is AD divided by hypotenuse. So AD divided by AB. Then cos of angle ABD, so here adjacent side of this angle is BD divided by hypotenuse, so BD by AB. And next tan of angle ABD, that is a AD divided by BD. Okay, so sine angle ABD is 60 degrees, so sine 60 degrees is equal to AD, that is a root 3A, so root 3A divided by AB is 2A. Cos 60 degree, that is BD, so A divided by AB 2A. And tan 60 degree, that is AD divided by BD, so root 3A upon A. Okay, so which value we will get? Sin 60 degree is equal to root 3 by 2, cos 60, that is 1 by 2, and tan 60, that is root 3. Okay, so from this 3 we will write another 3, again same, cosec 60 degree, that is a reciprocal of sin 60 degree. So sin 60 is root 3 by 2, cosec 60 is 2 divided by root 3. Sec 60 degree, that is a reciprocal of cos 60, cos 60 is 1 by 2, so sec 60 is 2 by 1, or you can write 2. And last one is cot 60, so cot 60 degree, that is a reciprocal of tan 60, tan 60 is here root 3, so cot 60 is here root 3 by 1, so if we take reciprocal, that is a 1 by root 3. Okay, so this is the value of trigonometric ratios of angles 60 degree. Okay, now we will take last one, that is a 45 degree. Okay, so trigonometric ratios of angles 45 degree. So now for this we have to consider a isosceles right triangle. Okay, trigonometric ratios of angle 45 degree. Okay, so for this we have to consider isosceles right triangle. So ABC is isosceles right triangle, so having side is suppose, means equal side is A. Okay, so here we have to write, first consider triangle ABC is an isosceles right triangle. Okay, having equal side A. Okay, now if this side is A, so by using Pythagoras theorem we can find AC side. Okay, so AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square, so A square plus A square, that is a 2A square, so AC square is equal to 2A square, so AC is equal to root 2A. Okay, so this is a root 2A. Now we know that this is isosceles right triangle, this angle is 90 degree, so by using angle sum property of triangle we will get both angle is a 45 degree. Okay, so you can consider any one of the angle to find the values of trigonometric ratios of angle 45 degree. Okay, so if I am considering this angle C, so sine of angle C is equal to, so how we find this, that is a AB by AC. Okay, sine definition of sine, that is opposite side by hypotenuse. So AB by AC, that is equal to, or first we have to write ratios, then cos C angle, that is adjacent side, so BC upon AC, and tan C angle, that is AB by BC. Okay, so here sine C angle having measure 45 degree, so sine 45 is equal to AB is A, AC is root 2A. Okay, cos C, that is BC is A, AC is root 2A, and tan, sorry, here write 45 degree, so cos 45, and then tan 45 degree is equal to AB by BC, that is A divided by A. Okay, so sine 45 we will get, that is 1 by root 2, A will get cancelled. Cos 45, that is again 1 by root 2, and tan 45, that is 1. Okay, and after that we can write cosec 45, sec 45, and cot 45. Okay, so cosec 45 degree, that is reciprocal of sine 45. So sine 45 1 by root 2, cosec 45 root 2. Sec 45 again reciprocal of cos 45. So this is 1 by root 2. So sec 45 is root 2. And then cot 45, that is a reciprocal of tan 45. So tan 45 here 1. So cot 45 also 1. Okay. So these are all values of trigonometric ratios of angles 0, 30, 45, 60 and 90. Now this all values we have to rewrite in one table. Now we will write all values in this one table. Okay. So trick is here. So first we have to write this numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Now divide this all numbers by 4. Okay, then simplify this. So 0 by 4, this is 0, 1 by 4 as it is, 2 by 4, we can write 1 by 2, 3 by 4 as it is, and 4 by 4 is 1. And write square root of these numbers in first row, that is the sine theta. So square root of 0, this is a 0, so sine 0 is 0. Sine 30, square root of this is a 1 by 2, so sine 30 is 1 by 2. Square root of this, so sine 45 is 1 by root 2. Okay, square root of this is a root 3 by 2, so sine 60 is root 3 by 2, and sine 90 is 1, square root of this. Okay, and after that you can write all the values. Okay, so if you know these values of sine theta for these angles, so you can write all values of this. Okay, so cos theta you have to write only in reverse order. So first write 1 here, then root 3 by 2, then 1 by root 2, then 1 by 2 is here, and then 0 is here. Okay, next, tan theta means sine theta divided by cos theta. So 0 divided by 1, 0. 1 by 2 divided by root 3 by 2, this 2 cancel, so this is 1 by root 3. 1 by root 2 divided by 1 by root 2, so this is 1. Root 3 by 2 divided by 1 by 2, so this is a root 3. And next is 1 divided by 0, so any number divided by 0 is not defined, so this is not defined. Okay, next, cot theta, this is a reciprocal of tan theta. So here tan 0 is 0, that is a 0 by 1. So if we take reciprocal, so 1 by 0. So this is not defined. So cot 0 is not defined. 1 by root 3, reciprocal of this, root 3 by 1. So that is a root 3. Reciprocal of this, 1. Reciprocal of this, 1 by root 3. And here it is a not defined. Okay. So that is a 1 by 0 or any number divided by 0. So here if we take reciprocal, so that is a 0. Okay, or you can write in reverse order. Not defined is here, then root 3, 1, 1 by root 3, 0. Okay, then cosec theta. Cosec theta is reciprocal of sine theta. So here 0 by 1, reciprocal 1 by 0, not defined. Next, 30 degree, 1 by 2, 2 by 1, 1 by root 2, root 2 by 1. This is a root 3 by 2, so reciprocal, that is 2 by root 3. And here 1 by 1 is there, reciprocal is 1. Okay, sec theta, it is a reciprocal of cos theta. So first 1 by 1, reciprocal is 1 again. Root 3 by 2, reciprocal 2 by root 3. This is a root 2 by 1 or root 2. This is 2 and this is a 0 by 1. So 1 by 0 is not defined. Okay. So now you have this table. Okay. Now we will solve examples based on this. Okay. Now I am keeping this and I will solve examples here. Okay. So now we will take examples. Now we will take two examples based on this. So first example is, question is like this way. Evaluate, first one is sine 60 into cos 30 plus cos 60 into sine 30. In the simplest form we have to evaluate. So sine 60, what is the value of sine 60? This is root 3 by 2. So root 3 by 2 multiplied by cos 30. So cos 30 is root 3 by 2 plus cos 60. Cos 60 is 1 by 2 and into sine 30. Sine 30 is 1 by 2. So if we simplify this, root 3 into root 3, this is 3, 2 into 2, 4, here 1 upon 4. So 3 by 4 plus 1 by 4, that is a 4 by 4. So answer is 1. Okay. Similarly, second one, sine 60 cos 45. So sine 60, what is sine 60? Root 3 by 2 into cos 45. Cos 45 is 1 by root 2 plus cos 60. Cos 60 is 1 by 2 and multiply by sine 45, that is a 1 by root 2. Okay, so root 3 upon 2 root 2 plus 1 upon 2 root 2. Okay, so if you write numerator common, that is a root 3 plus 1 divided by 2 root 2. Okay, so value of this is root 3 plus 1 upon 2 root 2. Okay, you can rationalize this, otherwise keep as it is. Okay, now in today's lecture we learn that how to find values of trigonometric ratios for angles 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree. Okay, and examples based on this. Okay, in next video we are going to learn more examples based on this one. Okay, that is the trigonometric ratios of some specific angles. Okay.